I am a direct descendant of King Kosoko of Lagos. I am the only child of Mustapha Lasisi Kosoko.
Okan soso tin se gbo, okan soso tin sodan, okan soso janaku ti minu gbo kijikiji.
I started acting precisely at the age of 10. That is 55 years ago. And I was stubborn. I always lead other children in doing funny things. In fact, some parents do not even want their children to come along with me because they believe I will influence them badly. You know, rafts. So we used to use them as boats. We off all our dresses, put them somewhere, and we were even swimming at the edge of the river. But when we finished and we were about to go, a madman had already carried all our clothes. In fact, we first made an attempt to collect back our clothes from the madman. He pursued us with stick. Ade was able to convince his own parents that we were attacked by a madman. In my own case, I dragged some clothes from the lining, you know, and cover myself up, you know, pretending that the beating they gave me in the morning is affecting me. Before 1964, I used to gather some of for some of the kids in the compound, because we have a very large compound. We used to gather somewhere, you know, at the back of the house, doing entertainment, whatever we see in the television. And people really love me the way I act. So one of our tenants, Uncle Dele Toibo, approached me and said, he can make use of me in their production. He belongs to the fellow who translated. So that was why he invited me. You know, we were there for auditioning, and I eventually won the, he gave me the role of Alabi in the production back on Juala. That was in 1964. And where it was recorded on NTA, on NTV then, Babish. Then we also staged at various places. In those days, when you are in the studio, they watch it at home immediately. And so I never knew they had laid ambushed for me. So I got another good beating of my life. Surprisingly, most of the people beating me now started shouting, "Ogunde, Ogunde," they left me, "Ogunde, Ogunde." Their one uncle, Yinka Jacobs, now said, "Why are you beating this boy now? That is the man he's trying to emulate. You all left him and start saying, Ogunde, Ogunde. So let's encourage him." Then I got a little freedom. They agreed, but with some conditions. Eventually, I became another good example for children in that environment. But my father would still manage to call me and advise me, "Look, you are a royal prince, Jide. You cannot be entertaining people. You should be entertained as a royal prince." So I said, "It's all right, but this is what I love." And I try as much as possible to adjust, but they eventually agreed with me. In 1972, when I eventually formed my own group, my father was there. Funny enough, I tell you something. My mother and father had been separated before that day, but my show brought them together again. And I started becoming a nice chap. Because since 1972, I started bringing smart things home. My first movie role was in a production titled Princely Prince. I just played a minor wakapas, you know, and I was paid. You know, I happen to be one of the co-pioneers of films in this country. There are a lot of challenges. Challenge of trying to have an industry, even without us knowing that we are building an industry. But when it comes to film, we, as leaders, we started bringing people in, and that is the problem we created for the industry ourselves. You know, everybody just comes in and do whatever they like. One of my trying moments was when I lost my wife, the first one, she was actually with me in my theater group. She supports me. When she left, you know, during childbirth, it pains me a lot. And less than a year after I left, I lost my first wife. She works with the customs then. And those periods were trying period. At the point I was the president of our association, ANTP then. And, you know, it was then the largest artist body in the country. So that means we run into thousands, and then we have quite a lot of people. You know, we have different members, people who are not really actors, but they are with us. They don't know they are below, they don't know how, what exactly brought them into the industry, but they are there. Especially when we eventually got Victor Ashaolu, you know, as a member of the association, and to us he was causing confusion here and there, and he wants to attain a position by all means, and members are not willing to give him such position. He took us to court. That was another serious challenge for me. You know, film industry in Nigeria, we in the Yoruba genre of the industry commercialized it. There have been films, but Ajani Ogo, Bayola Balogun, was to me the first commercially successful film in Nigeria, because Ola Balogun used the already popular Alarijo theater, the Yoruba theater groups, you know, we were then popular on stage. So he used us for the film, especially using Late Duro Ladipo and Adeyemi Afolayo Adilove, you know, to star the film. And surprisingly, for the first time, people rushed to the cinema to watch these films. So, thereafter, Adilove also did his own, Ija Obinira. Baba Ogunde Aye, Ojoladipo, with Ogun Ajayi, and several others. I also did Ojiji, and so many other films like that. It was in 1985, during the Structural Adjustment Program, SAP, when Naira was devalued, and we couldn't raise enough Naira to buy dollars for the post-production of our films. That was when we did Arumire of Blessed Memory, tried his hand on a video, home video. We didn't like it at all. We believe he's trying to spoil the film industry, but then we don't know when phones will be coming for us to start shooting on celluloid again. Because, you know, in those days, we cannot complete the post-production of our films here locally. I made bold to say that my contribution to the industry is not small at all. If you want to be a professional actor, you must be trained. It's either you go to the university to have it, or get, you know, registered with some of the existing groups. It is important. If you are not trained, especially the ladies, if you get crashed, then don't say anybody is harassing you, trying to exchange sex for role. They will, because you get crushed. But if you are trained and you know what you are, they will respect you, give you what you deserve, and sky will be your starting point.